So here I am on the desktop. I located my web zip folder. I'm going to double click on it. Now there's a web folder in there. I'm going to click and drag it to the desktop. I'm going to close this window. Now I should have two folders. I want to delete the zipped one. We cannot work with it. So now I have my unzipped web folder. Now this is the one I can work with. So let's open this up and let's see what we have. I notice I have three files here. I have an audio file, I have a what's called an HTML file, and I have a video. Now there's different ways of looking at this. We can look at details, and now we notice we have our files look a little different. One thing we need to do is we need to activate the file extensions. I cannot see what type of file this is, so I want you to go to Organize, Folder and Search Options. Under the View tab, click on the View tab. Don't even scroll down, no need to scroll down. Just look at the list. The second to the last item says Hide Extensions for Known File Types. Uncheck that. Click Apply. Click OK, and now we can see the file extensions on each of these documents. There's a lot of multitasking going on in this project. First thing we want to do is rename our HTML document. We're going to rename it. We're going to put our last name, followed by first name, followed by web A. Now if we double click on it, that we get this, we're able to view that HTML document using the browser. We can either use Internet Explorer or Firefox or Google Chrome, whichever you prefer. And so this is the contents of the document. Now I want to modify this, so I need to look at the code of how I modify this HTML document. So let's go back to our folder. So I want to see the code in this file. How do I do that? Let's go to the Start button at the bottom left. Click on that. We're going to type Notepad. We're going to notice the program Notepad comes up. We click on Notepad. Okay, we go to File, Open. Let's go to Desktop. We're going to locate our web folder. And we shouldn't see anything there because it wants to open all the text documents. So at the bottom right, we click on Text Documents arrow, click All Files. Now we should see our three documents. I locate my HTML file, I click on that or double click. Now I get to see the code. So pretty much whatever code, if I change the code here, if I change the code, anything having to do with the code here, I should be able to see the changes on my web page in my browser. So first thing I want to do is we could change the title, sure. So currently it says this is an example. This is what we're going to change. So I could just put my first web page as a title. Anytime I make a change to it, I want to go to File, Save, and then I refresh, and I should see the change there. If we also see this web page, we notice I have my name there. We have some text here. This is an example of a GIF image, an example of an animated GIF image. So our job is to place references to images in these blank areas. That's how we're going to finish this Web 8 project. So if I take a look at my code, I want to show you first of all some of the popular tags in HTML. The first one at the top is open bracket HTML close bracket. Next one is the title tag. Okay, this is what we call an open tag, and this is what we call a closed tag. The difference is that one has the closed tag has the backslash, open tag does not. Now why do we have an open and closed tags? Is the reason why is because whatever's in between, that's what gets applied. That's what you apply to the title. So if you were to have this title tag all the way down here, then everything in between would be considered the title. Next one is the body tag. And if we scroll down, we see the body tag below and the HTML tag also, the close tags. We have a couple of comment tags here, and notice that you don't see them on the web page. Okay, these are just for documentation purposes when someone needs help. All right, go ahead and you should be able to change your delete my name and put your name on there. I'm just going to put number one on there. And then I'm also going to look below, and these are what we call paragraph tags. They create space. We have another comment tag below, place a reference to a GIF image. This is an example of a GIF image. And we see that here. This is an example of a GIF image. So this is a first block that represents this text. The second block represents the next text, and so on and so forth. This is code to insert an image, a GIF image. So my job is to find a GIF image and place a reference to that image here. So let's do that. First step I want to do, I want to go to my web browser, and I open up a new tab and I go to Google Images. So once I'm at Google, I go to Images. Now here I'm going to look for an image. Let's type GIF logo. Let's search for it and let's see what comes up. Just for example purposes, let's choose this NASA picture, NASA logo. I'm going to click on that. Now, what I always like to do is I like to view the image completely. Now I see the entire image the way the size is. I right click on the image, save picture as. I'm going to save it to the folder where I have. I want to save it to the exact folder where I have my HTML document, which is located on the desktop under a folder called web. And notice it's a GIF image, so I leave that there. I want to change the name. I don't like complicated names. It has a dash there. It's kind of long. I like to keep it short. I make sure that the name is always lowercase. So I'm going to keep it simple, just NASA. I click on save. Okay, now I go back to my code and I change the reference here to NASA. Every time I make a change to the document, I have to make sure I save it. Now I go back to my web page. I refresh. I can also press F5 on the keyboard or just click the refresh button. And if it doesn't show up, see that the number one came up, but the image didn't show up, but I have all my code is correct. This may happen to you. So I'm glad it happened to me, because then I could show you what you can do to fix this problem. So in case this problem occurs, go to your web page, right click, go to open with, and use another browser. And as you can see, the other browser, it worked and it opened it up. So your job is to find an animated, so here it says below place of reference to an animated GIF. Your job is to find an animated GIF, change the code here, find a JPEG image, change the code here. Now the difference between a GIF or GIF image and a JPEG image is that a GIF only supports 256 colors. A JPEG image supports millions of colors. The next part here below says below place a reference to a video. Well, in the folder I'm giving you a video, so all you have to do is give the proper name of the video here. Change that to video. Same thing here, I give you an audio file that you can place instead of having blank, and that is this file right here. So all you're doing is changing the reference to it. So let me show you an example of how your project should look once it's done. So here's an example of what your project should look like. I have a regular GIF image. I have an animated GIF image. You see how there's some type of animation going on? And if you get this allow block content, you want to make sure to accept it, because now you're able to see the video and the audio. You can hear the audio. So you can see the video, you can hear the audio file, and you have your JPEG image there. And now my Web 8 project is complete. So now let me show you how to submit this project. I like to close everything. So I close it all. And I locate my folder where I have my project at. And now I need to zip it. I need to zip this folder. The reason we zip it is because by zipping it, the computer treats it as one unit as opposed to a folder with a bunch of files in it. So I'm going to right click and I go to send to, and I go to compressed folder, okay. Now I get this web.zip folder. I need to rename it, change it to last name followed by first name followed by web A. You leave the .zip there, and this is what you will submit. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.